Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Yes, Have Some. Today, we are taking a look at the brand new Wave 2 of the 40th anniversary Empire Strikes Back action figures. This is Star Wars The Black Series on the retro cards. This is Yes, Have Some Unboxed. Welcome back to the channel. Once again, my name is Craig Goldberg. Thank you so much for joining Yes, Have Some. We have the Empire Strikes Back 40th anniversary figures here. This is Wave 2 of the line, and this has a couple of figures that I have been dying to get my hands on.
My lord, we have them.
Including the brand new Luke Skywalker Snowspeeder figure, the first time ever in the line for the Black Series Rebel Hoth Soldier. We've got our updated Lando Calrissian figure from The Empire Strikes Back, including the new face scan with the real face technology that Hasbro uses. We've got our Dagobah R2-D2. Just to find an R2-D2 Black Series figure in any form in the stores is awesome. And then we've got our re-release of the Imperial TIE Fighter. Have not seen this one in the line for a couple of years. An amazing wave of figures. We're going to get into these right now. Let's go. All right, here we go. So first up, we've got our Rebel Hoth Soldier. This is based on the original Kenner release of the Rebel Hoth Soldier, and the first time that this has ever been done for Black Series. So really an amazing recreation of the original Star Wars Empire Strikes Back Kenner packaging. They did this for the 40th anniversary of A New Hope a couple years ago and have brought it back this year. The back of the packaging is all the same, just shows what is in Wave 2 of the line.
And also, if you enjoy what we're doing here at Yes Have Some, make sure that you subscribe to the channel and leave a comment. Let us know what you're excited about for the rest of the year when it comes to Star Wars The Black Series.
Now, I am a big Black Series collector. It is my preferred line of figures when it comes to Star Wars. Super excited to see a couple really great re-releases and new figures make it into this wave specifically. Okay, here it is. So let's take a close look at the figure itself. Really amazing detailing here with the Rebel Hoth Soldier. He's got his green goggles there at the top, a holster on the side of the leg, and then his communications pack. Is that what that is? Oh boy, they're gonna kill me.
Don't kill me, man! Don't kill me! Don't kill me, man!
And it does look like that is removable, which is very cool. We'll go ahead and snap that back for a second. Short blaster, standard Rebel issue, I'm assuming, and that fits nicely into the holster there. And then, of course, the rifle blaster as well. So I've removed his goggles and took off the bandana, and we're going to go ahead and take a look at the first time ever in the line face swapping technology. This is not an alternate head. It's an actual faceplate that can be removed to create a second Hoth soldier, which means exactly, you're going to have to probably get two of these figures. Let's go ahead and take a look at what that process looks like. So as you can see, you've got the hat and scarf there coming down. You're going to actually pop that portion off, okay? And it's hollow on the inside, and the face comes off.
Wait, you get looking.
And if you go to the pack that we talked about here, that pops off. Okay, and then there's a little compartment right here, and this is kind of hidden. It's not very self-explanatory. It's a good thing you're watching this video. That's all I'm saying. And you're going to pop that off, and then your alternate face is in there. So very, very cool. I like the idea of changing things up, giving more options, more opportunity for play and displayability. We'll go ahead and close that guy back up. So obviously no face. This is a bearded Hoth soldier. We'll put his hat back on. So there you have it. You've got a different face altogether, which really is genius. And another reason why this is probably my favorite figure in this entire wave. Absolutely incredible. All right, next up, we've got our Imperial TIE Fighter, one of the original releases in the Star Wars Black Series years and years ago. All right, cool. So there is our TIE Fighter. As you can see, your Imperial TIE Fighter in all black, decked out with that amazing face mask, everything that you remember from the original movie. And he comes with a single blaster as well. All right, next up, we've got the man, probably my favorite character in all of Star Wars, Lando Calrissian. This is a repack from a figure that was released a couple years ago, but it was before Hasbro was doing the facial scan technology, which they are now becoming known for. We've got Lando Calrissian there in his famous blue ensemble, different shades of blue. We've got the navy blue pants and the black belt. And then, of course, that sky blue famous shirt that he wore in Empire and that amazing cape. This is not a soft goods cape. It is a rubber cape. It does stay in place nicely, though, on his shoulders. This is a re-release. So let's go ahead and take a look at the original Lando figure and see what has been updated and if it is worth picking this one up, even if you already have the original. So obviously we can see immediately there is significant difference in the paint application. The original Lando there, I mean, it's not terrible looking by any means, but compared to what they have with the new figure, it's really not a comparison. If you have the ability to pick this up, I definitely would. The hair is a little bit darker. The skin tone is just a touch darker, more accurate to what you would have seen with Billy Dee Williams there on screen in Empire Strikes Back. And then the face likeness, I mean, really night and day. I would say a 1000% improvement over this original figure. So this guy, unfortunately, will be replaced. And that is what I love about these re-releases. I know some people don't like the repacks. They only want new figures. But to get an updated version of a figure that maybe left a little bit to be desired originally, I think is a win-win situation. Boom. Dagobah R2-D2. What an incredible figure and an incredible movie and an incredible character. Who doesn't love R2? All right, there it is. R2 looking great there. Obviously, it has the paint application to represent the Dagobah system when he and Luke go and visit Yoda in Empire Strikes Back. So you kind of have a rough around the edges, swamp-like, very dirty R2-D2 here. And he's got the antenna there popping out the top, which I believe can be replaced. It's got a little replacement part there. This is going to go absolutely perfect with the upcoming release from Hasbro, the Dagobah Yoda and Luke 2-pack, which will be hitting shelves later this summer. I want a Dagobah diorama and I want an X-Wing in 6-inch scale. Is that too much to ask for? R2 always sells quickly, always a hard figure to get in the line. So to be able to pick him up for $20 at my local Target was awesome. And of course, the antenna at the top is removable and it does come with the replacement piece, and that just snaps right in. There you have it. So you can do antenna or no antenna. I like it with the antenna, but I wanted to show you guys what that looks like. All right, last, I'm very excited about this figure as well. We've got Luke Skywalker in his snow speeder uniform, similar to the X-Wing uniform. I'm gonna go ahead and pull that out as well in just a moment so we can compare. All right, there you have it. Luke Skywalker in his Rebel Hoth Snowspeeder gear. There is a Snowspeeder being released in the Black Series scale later this summer, so that's going to be a must-have pickup. Really nice detailings there. He's got his two pouches there in the back, and obviously that famous Luke helmet, which I believe is removable, and then, of course, the blue lightsaber there. There it is, and there are some differences here that we can point out. So the vest is basically the same. It's painted with a very similar application. Some subtle differences, but nothing to really point out. I will say that the new release Snowspeeder uniform is a little bit darker in the shade of orange used. Obviously, the strapping is a little bit different. Here we've got Luke wearing kind of his Hoth overcoat, which keeps the straps on the underneath there, and then he's got the belt on with the pouches. So definitely a different figure, and not just a straight re-release or repaint, which they probably could have easily gotten away with. And then obviously we've got the different boots there, the Snowspeeder Luke with the striped gray and white boots, and then the original black boots on the A New Hope X-Wing Luke. All right, and there we have it, our complete wave 2 of the Star Wars The Empire Strikes Back 40th anniversary retro Kenner carded figures. This is part of the Star Wars Black Series, and really, they did an amazing job. These are must-haves, and listen, even if you don't collect Black Series, this would be a good place to start because you get a nice variety. You've got a Luke, you've got Lando, you've got some side characters like the Rebel Hoth Soldier, which that facial scan kind of looks like Walton Goggins. I'm just putting it out there. Hey, I want to see Walton Goggins in a Star Wars movie. Why not? And then, of course, we've got the Dagobah R2 and our Imperial TIE fighter. Have another close look at these guys, and we're going to be getting out of here in just a moment. Really, really enjoy being able to collect these figures. Really love being able to find them in stores earlier than we thought. Thank you so much for joining us again for Yes Have Some Unboxed. Thank you so much for subscribing to the channel. If you haven't yet, make sure you click that subscribe button. We got a lot more unboxings coming your way. Until next time, my name is Craig Goldberg, and this has been Yes Have Some Unboxed.